My name is Mernush Malikian. I'm here for my procedure with Dr. Allaei. He's going to do RFA on my thyroid nodule.
Hi, I'm Dr. Allaei, and I'm a double board certified vascular and interventional radiologist specializing in image guided procedures. So I've been in practice for over 10 years, and as an image guided specialist, I have performed many ablations throughout the body using different modalities. So today I will be seeing our patient Mernush, who's coming in for a thyroid nodule in the middle of her neck that has been causing her some compression, pressure symptoms in her neck, and also has a cosmetic appearance that she would like resolved. Now this nodule, this right here is your breathing tube, okay? You're called your trachea, okay? And then this nodule sits right on top of your breathing tube, and then this is your skin. And then your other nodule is even smaller. So yeah. We don't need to do anything about that. This was kind of the one that was concerning for you, mm-hmm. Okay? So that's the one we're treating, okay? Now, one of the risks of this procedure that we talked about is that, you know, when we're burning this nodule, the heat spreads, okay? Just like a hot pan or hot stove, when you get closer it gets hotter. So it's the same with the probe. And so in order for me to do this safely, I have to infuse very cold liquid in between your airway here and the nodule here, okay, so that none of that heat goes to your breathing tube, okay?
So I know that Dr. Allaei is a very good doctor. He's done this many times, so I have complete faith in him. And I'm a little bit nervous about the whole procedure, of course. I think that's normal. But yeah, I'm happy. It's been a long journey. I waited about 1 year to get here. So yeah, I'm happy.
There are different types of ablation modalities that can be used to shrink tissues. And the decision on the modality is based on the organ, anatomy, risks, and doctor's preferences. So our patient being treated today has a thyroid nodule that lies directly in the middle of her neck. Now what is unique about this particular thyroid nodule is that it's small and lies on top of the breathing tube called the trachea. So treatment in this area is very complex and high risk, as the nodule is next to the breathing tube and the skin, and this could result in complication if not done properly. So this should really be only performed by an ablation expert that has a lot of experience in ultrasound guided images. Additionally, if the operator is not visualizing the needle during the entire procedure, it can puncture that breathing tube as well, causing bleeding. In addition to good technique, there are several methods that need to be applied before doing a delicate RFA procedure like this to minimize these risks. The most important of which is called hydrodissection. And that is the infusion of cold, sterile water around the nodule. And this fluid needs to be precisely placed in the correct area to absorb that heat during the ablation procedure. So because her lesion is, nodule is looking in a certain place, we want to minimize the heat leaving the nodule. So we've done hydrodissection, and that's kind of put some cold liquid around the nodule to absorb the heat. But we also want to use a small probe that has a more precise targeted heat to the tissue. And so we're using the StarMed. I like using this probe because we don't need to make any incisions. It's very precise. We're going to give more precise targeted heat to that tissue so it doesn't leave. These structures are very sensitive to heat, which can melt or burn. For example, you can put a hole in the breathing tube requiring surgery, or you can get a skin burn or ulcer as a result of it. I've been in practice for over 10 years, and as an image-guided specialist, I have performed many ablations throughout the body using different modalities. And this experience in ablation, along with many years of using ultrasound to do procedures, allows me to confidently take on complex cases. Okay, we're all done. All right, so we're all done. You did great.
Then Brown and the doctor said, and he was able to take all the nodules out. So I'm so happy to hear that.
So today's procedure was very successful. I was able to separate the nodules safely from both the breathing tube and skin, which allowed me to maximize the area for a safe ablation. Now, We will need to give some time for the nodule to shrink, and I will see her back in 3 months. So I'm expecting to see great results when she comes for a follow-up.
My name is Mare. I'm here for my 3 months follow-up with Dr. Allaei for my RFA procedure. I had a little bit of a bruising and pain. I took the medication that doctor prescribed for me. It was not as hard as I imagined, so it was easier.
Hi there.
Hi
Dr. Allaei, how are you? Good to see you. Nice to see you.
Nice to see you again.
Okay, so this is your 3 month follow-up, right?
Yes.
Okay. So now we have the before and after. So you can see this was your nodule before, okay? And then this is your nodule after. So dark means it's dead. So it's a dead nodule, which is what we wanted to do. So these are the new measurements. This was the size before that we measured of this one, okay? So the volume was 11.8, okay? So it's a three-dimensional structure. And your new volume is 2.59, okay? So that means it shrunk 79%. Okay, so that's very good.
From the beginning that I was diagnosed with thyroid nodule, I couldn't lay down. It was hurtful when I lay down, when I was eating. I could feel the nodule going up and down. I'm pretty happy with my results. Doctor told me that I had 79% shrinkage in volume, which is awesome for my case. I wished doctors would tell this procedure exists. I found it myself off the internet, and I wish it was more common in other states. I would recommend Dr. Allaei to anyone who wants to have this procedure done.
So in the case of Mehrnush, this was a complex high-risk RFA procedure. Now I know the ablation had gone really well, so I was confident she was gonna see great results today. And this was confirmed by the ultrasound and her smile. Post-op visits are actually the most rewarding part of doing procedures. I love to see those smiles and results. Now that we have those, I can go have a nice weekend.